everyone, assalamu alaikum, welcome back to Dr. Teeth. In this video, we are going to talk about the Norma Frontalis, which means the front of the skull, means you are viewing the skull from the front, or it is also called as the anterior aspect of the skull. Now, when you look at the skull from the front, there are few bones that we will find. We have the frontal bone, which is here. We have the right and the left nasal bone, which is here. Right and the left maxilla, which is here. Right and the left zygomatic bone, which makes up our cheekbone. And then we have one mandible. So these are the bones you will see when you look at the skull from the front. Now let us see at the different features we find, or different, you know, anatomical characteristics of Norma Frontalis. The first one we are going to talk about is the forehead. Now the forehead is formed by the frontal bone. Then we have the frontal prominence. So if you look at yourself in the mirror, you will find that you have a prominence towards the head region. That is the frontal prominence. It is low round elevation, which is seen above the superciliary arches. Now this is the superciliary arches. Okay, it is made up from the bony elevation, which is present at the superior aspect of the orbit. This is our orbit. Above it, we have a superior elevation. Okay, and above it, we have a prominence on the frontal bone that is called as the frontal prominence. Then we have the glabella. Now, glabella, if you look in between the two superciliary arches, you will find another elevation. That elevation is the glabella. It is a median elevation between the superciliary arches. Then let's talk about the orbits in detail. Now, orbits are what? These are basically cavities, okay? A hole or a cavity in which the eyeballs sit. Now, each of these cavity, it has four boundaries, okay? We have the superior boundary, that is the supraorbital margin. We have the infraorbital margin. We have the lateral margin, and we have the medial margin. Now, supraorbital margin is, as you can see, it is formed by the frontal bone, okay? Now, if you start from the lateral aspect of the supraorbital margin and you travel 2/3 distance, and then you come from the medial aspect of this margin and you travel 1/3 distance, you will find a notch here. A notch here, or in many cases, a foramen here, okay? That is called as the supraorbital notch or foramen in some skulls. And this is the place, this is the hole through which the nerves and the vessels, what nerves and vessels? Supraorbital nerves and vessels will be passing. Now, just medial to this notch, you will have supratrochlear nerves and vessels passing through, okay? Then we have the lateral orbital margin, which is formed by two bones, which is the zygomatic bone below and the frontal bone above, okay? So, this is the lateral margin of the orbit. Then we have the infraorbital margin, which is formed by the zygomatic bone, which is our cheekbone laterally, and then the maxilla, okay? So this forms the infraorbital margin. Now below this margin, you will find another foramen, that is the infraorbital foramen, where the infraorbital nerves and vessels will be passing. Then we have the medial orbital margin. It is not as well defined as the other margins. So on the medial surface, you will find a little depression instead of an elevation. It's not as prominent as other margins, right? And it is formed by the frontal bone above and the lacrimal crest of the maxilla below. It is formed by the frontal bone above, okay? And the lacrimal crest of the maxilla, okay? This entire maxilla, the lacrimal crest of the maxilla, okay? Then we have the anterior nasal aperture. This opening for the nose is the anterior nasal aperture. Just above it, you will find the external nose, okay? And within this aperture, we have a separation in the center, okay? That is known as the nasal septum, and we have few conchae. This is the superior nasal concha, and below it, this one right here, this is the inferior nasal concha. Then we have the nasion. To understand the nasion, first let us see what sutures comprises of nasion. So we have the frontal bone, we have the nasal bone. So suture between these two will be the frontonasal suture. And these two are the nasal bone, and there will be a suture between these two. This will be the internasal suture. So there is a point, okay, which is a median point where the internasal and the frontonasal sutures meet, that is known as the nasion. Okay, let's talk about the anterior nasal spine. It is a bony projection, as you can see here, just at the inferior aspect of the nasal aperture. If you look closely at the mandible here at this region, you will find that there is a slight bony prominence. Now, this represents that the mandible was formed in two parts and was, you know, fused in the center. That is known as the symphysis menti. Now, below the symphysis menti, if you move here, you will find a triangular elevation. This triangular elevation is known as the mental protuberance. And this gives the prominence to our chin. Okay. Then we have the nathion, which is also known as the mental point. It is the midpoint of the base of the mandible. Then we have the mental foramen. So we have another foramen in the mandible. We have actually many foramen in the skull. We'll be studying about it in detail in the future. But for now, just focus that we have a mental foramen, very important foramen for the mandible. And it is seen between the two premolar teeth. Okay. So here we have two premolar, first premolar, second premolar. In between them, we have a hole here, which is basically a foramen, and that is known as the mental foramen. Okay. And then we have the oblique line on the mandible. Oblique line of the mandible, it extends from this mental protuberance all the way to the ramus of mandible. Now, what is the ramus of mandible? So, if you look at the mandible from the side, okay, like this. This portion right here, this is the ramus, and this is the body of the mandible. So, it arises from the body, from the mental protuberance, and then it goes to the anterior aspect of the ramus of the mandible. So, that is about the oblique line on the body of mandible. With this, we have completed the norma frontalis. We'll be covering norma lateralis in the next video. Till then, take care. Al-Hafiz.